Well, as the phone hacking scandal in Britain continues to unfold on a daily basis, storm clouds are gathering over Prime Minister David Cameron. He closed his close connections rather to the embattled Rupert Murdoch's media empire has seen him facing some difficult questions in Parliament Day. Well, let's cross live now to London, where RT's Laura Emmett standing by for us. Laura, you've been following this very closely for us, I know, and it looks like one of Cameron's hardest days since he took over in the PM's chair. Doesn't it?
That's right. He's faced some very tough questions from other MPs in the House today about his own involvement, essentially, in this phone hacking scandal. It's been revealed that he had extensive meetings or has had extensive meetings during the 15 months that he's been in office with all sorts of executives from News Corp and from News International. 26 meetings in 15 months. That's a lot for a Prime Minister to have. He's also faced tough questions about his hiring of Andy Coulson as his director. Director of Communications. Andy Coulson was, of course, a former News of the World journalist, editor, who was being investigated back in 2009 as part of that original investigation into phone hacking. David Cameron said that if Coulson knew about the hacking that was going on inside his paper, then he lied to everybody, including several counts of perjury where he lied under oath, and so he would be prosecuted for that. And he also said that if Coulson had lied to him, to David Cameron, then he would apologise for that. He's stopped short of apologising so far. We're seeing new allegations surface all the time. There's something to do with this other News of the World journalist, Neil Wallace, who was hired as a consultant for the police. It also seems now that he was advising Andy Coulson ahead of the general election, but Cameron said very clearly that he wasn't ever employed by the government and that he had never been paid by the Conservative Party to do that. He's also faced repeated questions about whether Cameron interfered in the Sky B deal that Rupert Murdoch was trying to push through. Did he have conversations with News Corp executives about the Sky B deal? He has refused to answer that really very directly, saying only that he's had no appropriate conversations, and so MPs have asked the question over and over again. This is really a web of scandal that we think is still unfolding, really, and it involves this tangled in the relationships between politicians and the police and the media, and Cameron has become more and more implicated as this scandal has gone on. It's now been revealed that his chief of staff allegedly asked Scotland Yard, the police force, not to brief the Prime Minister on the phone hacking investigation as it was going on, and people are now asking whether that was willful ignorance on the part of the chief of staff and on the part of the Prime Minister. Did he want to avoid knowing about the investigation? I'm not usually a betting woman, but I have looked at a couple of betting shops and the odds that they're offering on Cameron being the next minister to leave office. At the beginning of the week, the odds were 100-1, and now they've dropped in some places to as low as 4-1. So people are also taking advantage of this situation. Of course, Ed Miliband, the leader of the opposition, has consistently stopped short of calling for the Prime Minister to resign, but he is going out of his way to set himself up as what he sees is a more trustworthy leader for the country. And of course, we've seen the Commissioner of the Metropolitan Police, Sir Paul Stevenson, on his resignation, saying essentially that he didn't see why he had to step down for hiring this News of the World journalist, Neil Wallace, when David Cameron doesn't have to step down for having hired Andy Coulson as his Director of Communications. So this is certainly not the end of this, and very serious for David Cameron.
Indeed, the scandal just rumbles on in London. Okay, Laura, many thanks for that. RT's Laura Emmett there.